MAX30100 sensor not working. No red LED on the MAX30100 sensor after all connections and programming done. If you are having a similar question in your mind or initializing pulse oximeter ... failed, initializing ... MAX30100 was not found, please check the wiring or power. If your serial monitor is showing the similar output and you are looking for the solution for these issues, then you have stumbled at the right place. This video will help you to solve all these issues. Take a deep breath, sit back and relax. We are going to solve all these issues in a few minutes. This video is brought to you by PCBWay.com. PCBWay.com is one-stop solution for all your PCB needs like PCB prototyping, assembly stencil, assembly and all. Currently, they are offering 10 pieces of 2-layer PCBs at just $5. So, get your PCBs ready at PCBWay.com. The link is in the description below. Now, let's dive into the episode. So, straight to the point, this problem with hardware only. There might be no problem with code or connection. I'm sure you have already re-verified the connection twice and tried with different examples of the code, but no use. Let's take a closer look at the schematic diagram of the sensor if we can figure out the issue from this. This is the schematic diagram of pulse oximeter sensor. As you can see here, there are two voltage regulators. This will give a constant output of 3.3 volts where the input can be anything from 1.8 to 5.5 volts. Coming to the second regulator, it will give a constant of 1.8 volts output when the input is 3.3 volts. This regulator is used to power up the MAX30100 sensing module, which requires only 1.8 volts. Up to here, everything is perfect. The main problem is with this connection only. As you can see here, these are the pull-up resistors, but they are connected to 1.8 volts to make it pull up. But the problem is our microcontrollers are 3.3 volts based. So these pull-up resistors are not making SDA and SCL data lines neither pull up nor pull down. Because of this connection, the data which is sending from the sensor to microcontroller being corrupted and we are getting responses as followed. Initializing pulse oximeter ... failed. Initializing ... MAX30100 was not found. Please check the wiring or power. Since the sensor cannot communicate with the microcontroller, this will never receive a command to read the pulse and oxygen levels. Thus, the red LED never glow. I think we understood the real problem. What should be the solution for this? Well, the solution is very simple. We just need to connect these pull-up resistors to the 3.3 volts network. That's it. That simple it is. But how to connect it or where to connect matters. There are two ways to do it. 1. Cut this line and connect this pull-up resistor with 3.3 volts pin of the regulator. You don't have to connect all resistors because all three resistors are internally connected on the PCB as shown here. Coming to the second method, simply remove these three resistors and connect an external 4.7 kΩ resistors on the breadboard. You don't have to cut the PCB lines here. Choose your feasible way and just do it. After successfully completing any of the ways, you can connect your sensor to any microcontroller and test it. I am sure it will work perfectly if you follow the right way. I have followed the both ways with two different sensors to demonstrate you. Both sensors are working absolutely fine. They are giving accurate heart rate and SpO2 data seamlessly with both ESP32 and ESP8266 modules as shown here. That's all about MAX30100 sensor troubleshooting for you. I hope this video helped you to solve the problem. Stay tuned to Electronics Innovation for more interesting projects and troubleshooting videos. If you are facing any other issues, just draft a mail to askus.electronicsinnovation@gmail.com. We will try to help you as soon as possible. See you on the next interesting episode. Bye-bye.